is 8 News Now at 6:30.
8 News Now is partnering with Metro Police to bring you our Cyber Safe Parents series in an effort to help you take care of your children online. Joining me now again is Detective Michael Fortunato with Metro's Internet Crimes Against Children Unit. And Detective, tonight we want to talk about devices and the fact that kids are so savvy with devices. You know, a parent might look at their kid on the phone and think, oh, they're using it to play music, but it is access and a portal to so much more. Talk about that.
Yes, it's one of those that a lot of times we get people, adults, that come in and say, hey, it's just a music player. Well, in reality, if you don't pay attention, a lot of times you can add applications to it, texting apps, some applications where you can turn it into an actual cell phone and make phone calls. So they need to make sure that they educate themselves to that, to what that device capability is.
For the parent that's saying, hey, every time I look at my kid, they're on their phone, they're looking at their phone, especially young kids, does that parent need to get the phone from their kid to look at exactly what is being done, what apps are on there? What are some specifics we can give those parents to make sure they're being proactive about this?
Best advice always is to physically look at the device. That's what's going to see what's going on at that time and everything like that. There is software out there that you can potentially put in the background that the child may not know about, but that's where you need to have a conversation with the child. Let them know that you're going to be doing that kind of stuff. But physically looking at it is probably the best course of action. The other thing I can always recommend is if you lower the storage amount on the device, it'll limit to what the capabilities of that device can do.
That's a great tip, and I want to circle back to something you've previously said to me. Keeping the devices, let's say if the kids are sleeping upstairs, downstairs, charged downstairs, so you know where those devices are, because if the kid has it at night, again, they could be getting into trouble.
Absolutely, because 9 times out of 10, they're probably going to be on there, or someone's going to reach out to them and wake them up, or vice versa, or any given situation that gives them the opportunity to unfortunately maybe get in trouble or get into something that's way over their head.
So for the parents that are watching this right now, it's as simple as saying, hand over the phone, I need to take a look. And how often do you recommend parents do it? Is it something they should be doing monthly or weekly?
In today's world, with the way kids are, I would say at least once a week. If you don't have the time, obviously, and everybody's busy schedule, I would say at least 2 or 3 times a month, just so you can kind of see what's going on, and just kind of track and make sure everything's okay with your child.
It's not, unfortunately, just listening to their favorite music. There's some bad stuff that they could be getting into, and we're giving you some tips on how to make sure that doesn't happen to your youngsters. Thank you so much for your time, Detective. If you missed any of this interview or you want to share it, it is on our website, LasVegasNow.com.